whenever somebody threw a birthday party, I would bring my laptop and put on my playlists. And then I was like, you know what, I actually want to do transitions too. So I bought like a controller and I started DJing. People came and I played cheerleader and they were all singing along and I was like, holy shit, they really know my stuff. Like, they're here for me. You know, I'm not just a local DJ anymore. People are buying tickets because they want to see me.
Oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader. She is always right there when I need her.
What caused the anxiety for me, like, mainly was being insecure and then being thrown into this crazy life.
In the midnight haze, we are sitting in the sun.
First hit started happening when I was 19 years old, and I grew up in a small village, but I hadn't really done much. Like, I was just a kid, and then suddenly I was touring the world. Like, I was to 50 countries now, even more actually, and I didn't even know who I am at that point, you know. I didn't have time to like be young, go out, like, explore the world, explore myself. So I think it was just a bit too much, and then being insecure and being exposed like that constantly, I think just brought the anxiety up. Tour's been crazy. Like, the past couple of years on tour, I experienced so much. It's hard to even summarize it in like an answer. There was like a lot of very, very good times to like traveling the world and like meeting so many people and playing huge crowds all over the world, to also like it being really like isolating and hard on my body, obviously, really tiring. Being on tour is like a completely different kind of life. I don't think it compares to any other life you can live, because you would be in a different city every day. Like, sometimes we did up to like 5 cities, 4 countries in 2 days. And it's like, you wake up in one, you do a show at noon, you fly to the next country, do another show at night, go to sleep for a couple of hours, fly to the next country. And like, there are a lot of sad moments on tour too. Well, I would like come home from like a big show with like 100,000 people, and then suddenly I'm all alone in my hotel room on the other side of the world, and all my friends and family are like somewhere, and I'm like, fuck, what am I even doing here? You know, what am I doing this for? So it's been like a lot of ups and downs. I feel like tour just intensifies everything a lot.
Close your eyes, make a wish.
At that time, when I was feeling anxious, it didn't really affect the music as much yet, but that's when I started to realize there's a disconnect, because I was putting out happy songs, but I didn't feel happy. And it was really weird for me to do the interviews and to do the promo and to be like the happy entertainer guy at all times, when inside I was feeling so sad. So that's when I started to be like, okay, let's write about self-love. Let's write about finding the truth about ourselves and all of that. And suddenly I felt it, like in the sessions I had goosebumps, and I was like, I was really into it. So that's when I found out what I wanted to do, and I was like, okay, this next album gonna be more personal.
When I should have looked in, I guess I've been looking in all the wrong places. Until I said, hey, how you doing? Yeah, I hope I'm well.
I started meditating like 3-4 years ago. A friend of mine who's a singer recommended me this app called Headspace, and that was like my way into meditation. And then I guess like a year ago I really got into it, starting like reading about Buddhism and stuff too. And I actually just came back from a Buddhist monastery where I went for a mindfulness retreat, so I went really all the way in with my meditation. The most current experiences of me, like going to the monastery and meditating and getting really deep into all of that, can be heard soon, because the songs that are coming out now were written like a year ago or something, and that's like when I was still a little bit in my darker times. So there's the singer we have with Gashi and Fangs called Sicko, which is like about me being emotionally sick.
I'll be like, I'm a sicko, no you don't know who you play.
now for this new project, I started to co-write all the lyrics, and I was like, okay, I want my music to have like a different level of meaning and purpose than only the entertainment factor. The music that I'm putting out now goes with my life. So as I get happier, the music will get happier too. But yeah, basically the songs are now like describing my life. But right now I feel so happy and good about myself that the songs we're writing right now here in LA, they're like super happy again. And it's back to like feel good music and just like living in the now and having a good time. So everybody was like getting a bit worried about me because we were putting out so many sad songs, they can look forward to some happy ones too now. In the next 5-10 years, like honestly, my only goal is to stay happy, to like live a peaceful life, to be a blessing, to be a sun for my surrounding, to shine. As long as you like go through this world with a clear mind, with an open heart, I think anything is possible, and I'm just excited for everything.